The liberals thought they were so clever with their identity politics charade. They weaponized feelings and political correctness, but now it has come back to bite them and their 2020 candidates square in the butt. It's open season on males, even the Democratic ones. Let's start with Beto, real name Robert O'Rourke. He's been raked over the identity politics, white guilt, and man-hating feminist coals, and I gotta say, it's hilarious. First, he caught grief for saying he was born to run for president. Yeah, that didn't go over so well with the white privilege police, who insisted born to run meant entitled to the White House because he's a white male. But then at a campaign stop, he joked about his wife raising their kids.
I just got a call from my wife, Amy, who's back in El Paso, Texas, where she is raising, sometimes with my help, Ulysses, who's 12 years old, Molly, who's 10, and their little brother, Henry, who is 8 years old.
Of all the stupid things Beto, real name Robert, has said, like tearing down the wall where it's already built, this is the remark you guys are so ticked off about? Really? So what did Beto, real name Robert, do? Well, he slathered up on the SPF 50 white guilt and apologized for being a man, being white, and basically being born.
I have enjoyed white privilege. Absolutely. Undeniable. I have been arrested twice in my life, one for attempted criminal trespass and another more graver offense of driving while intoxicated. Those mistakes didn't end up defining me or narrowing my options in life. And it's not because I'm a great person or I'm a genius or I figured anything out. A lot of that has to do with the fact that I'm a white man.
Great stuff, guys. The pretty boy of the DNC is getting eaten alive by his own, and all we can do is sit back and say, I told you so.